31st October 2018 marked the inauguration of arguably the most iconic structure of modern-day infrastructure, a structure that highlights the sheer genius of individuals in the AEC industry. Any guesses what we are talking about? We are talking about the Statue of Unity, the world's tallest statue with a height of 182 meters, located in the state of Gujarat, India. Well, let us help you visualize just how tall the structure is. The statue that comes second is the Spring Temple Buddha in China, standing at 128 meters. That's a huge gap. But why are we telling you about it? Because it is directly related to the title of our video. Trust us. The Statue of Unity is a great case study to understand how civil and structural engineers proficient in BIM are getting greater recognition and better career opportunities.
When we talk about Statue of Unity, like I said, it's one of the most important project in the last few years for our country. It was a project of national importance. A lot of many engineers, a lot of many architects, a lot of many specialists came together on board to make it a success. It was not possible by only one team's effort. And there has been negotiations of BIM across the project which made sure that the timelines were met, which made sure that the quality of the outcome which you see right now standing there tall is achieved, and all of the results are directly and indirectly being impacted by BIM adoption altogether in different stages of the construction. This kind of structure was a bit of a complex scenario because it was not a regular form of building. So you have to make sure that you're using the right plugins, the right tools to do it. So that was essential. And I think the 3D modelers did a great job. We did a build, the overall building was built in LOD 300 to 350. And the intent was to make sure that we do all the next levels of things, which is simulations in terms of safety planning, logistics planning, also taking care of construction sequencing, because that was very important in this type of projects. These are like not typical projects. And once we move on to the modeling part, the next part which was also covered in the form of BIM implementation on the project was basically 4D sequencing. Now, when we talk about building of statues, there's also contextual data available, like the geography is not so very common. It's not a barren land. We are actually dealing on the banks of a river and there's a dam associated to it. So we have to make sure that the sequencing is in such a manner that there is no risk and calamities happening in the future. So to make sure that each of the sequences for the are synced with the schedules, the schedule optimization could be done correctly and the timeline could be matched, 4D applications are used like Synchro and Navisworks, where we make sure that the sequencing was simulated as shown to the project managers and executives. Coming up to all of these things, I think the opportunities for BIM, especially for engineers, are immense. There's a lot to be done on engineering and construction front. I think there are different sectors which all of this could be catered and taken care of by adoption of BIM or digital tools. So I think we should be talking about this much more often and try to understand how we can disrupt the industry altogether as an engineer.
When we researched the job market to get a better understanding, we observed similar trends. Companies across the globe are investing heavily in hiring skilled BIM engineers. Be it job openings at L&T, Atkins, WSP or any top firm, everyone is looking to hire skilled BIM professionals. Let's scroll through a few openings for you. Let's stop this one by Rambo. See how it specifically talks about hiring a BIM modeler with hands-on knowledge of Revit, Navisworks, experience in stages of drawings, robust knowledge of BIM standards, and so on. Essentially, what BIM will enable you to do is have a specialized career path. And not just that, it enables a financially secure and growing career. We've done some extensive research to specifically talk about the salaries of BIM-skilled engineers. Several reports and figures talk about the average salary of BIM engineers across the globe. It is $73,000 per year in the United States, £40,000 in the United Kingdom, 72,000 dirhams in the UAE, 5 lakh rupees in India, and so on. And of course, this is just an average of what an early career professional can earn. It is not a benchmark. You'll find people who will be earning more or less than this. When we compare that to non-BIM professionals in the space, we see quite a significant gap. A BIM-skilled engineer is typically paid 40 to 80% more than other professionals with similar experience. That is huge. But why are BIM-skilled engineers being paid more than others? Let's understand that with these 3 points. BIM is a tech-enabled methodology which makes it highly scalable across projects, cities, and countries. And of course, if there's a skill that's highly scalable, you know how that rewards professionals. Ask your coder friends about it. BIM severely reduces human effort and automates phases throughout the project lifecycle, ensuring that there's a massive boost in productivity and efficiency. It also gives professionals the power to visualize, analyze, and mitigate various real-world scenarios even before the project starts getting built. Doesn't that feel like a superpower? And lastly, the supply-demand cycle. There are not a lot of skilled BIM professionals in the industry, and the demand is rising steeply. So, if you make the cut, even the sky is not the limit for you. Now let's deep dive into the career trajectory of a BIM engineer. So typically, you'll start your career as a BIM engineer, where you'll spend about 2 to 3 years before transitioning into the role of a senior BIM engineer. Around the 3 to 5 year mark is when you'll typically be a BIM coordinator. The main scope of a BIM coordinator is to coordinate between different disciplines involved in the project. Their role is to look at the BIM model and ensure that there are no clashes which can come up in the future. After another 2-3 years, you'll be in a position of a BIM manager. The most important skill at this stage is people management. The salaries from this role onwards also grow in compounding effect as you are now in a managerial role. You'll be defining the BIM specifics for the project, the BIM execution plan, requirements with the contractors, the expectations of the client, and so on. And at roughly a 9 to 12 years work ex in the industry, you will become a BIM director. Now, if you see the typical career path of a non-BIM professional, it takes them around 19 to 20 years to become the head engineer. So we guess it is clear now. BIM is the career booster we all have been looking for. If someone were to tell me that I can reach a better designation and save 5 full years doing that, I'd be happily willing to invest in that skill. And if you're like me, then head to our website to check out our BIM professional course for civil engineers. The link is in the description. To help you further, we have an exhaustive video on the top companies you can apply to and how you can go about the application process. Make sure to click on the video on your screen. Till then, stay curious and be in charge.